Houston Rockets pull it out in game 5, 98-94, and are now up 3-2 on the Golden State Warriors. What's going on, y'all? 5 Sports Talk back at it with another video talking, of course, some NBA talking, some NBA playoffs, of course. And the Warriors, folks, are now on the brink of elimination. The Warriors and both LeBron James and Cleveland Cavaliers one game away from being eliminated. Unreal. Never thought this would happen. Did not expect this, but here we are, right? So the Warriors pull it out. This is the second game in a row where it's kind of come down to like the last minute or so, which is good for us fans, right? Watching the game. And the Warriors have lost both games. The Rockets have come out on top both games. That we did not, of course, see coming. I didn't see coming. But Houston has now shocked us, and they're up 3-2. So what happened? How did Houston pull it out? What can we expect moving forward in this series? And are the Rockets now poised to go to the NBA Finals? Okay, let's start first and foremost with what the heck happened tonight. And I'm telling you, what happened tonight was CP3. This man is on a mission, and he played like it again tonight. What did he have? 20 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists, 3 steals. Folks, James Harden had an abysmal game. I believe he's missed, what, 19 threes, something like that. He was just awful today. 19 points, 3 rebounds, 4 assists. That's a very subpar James Harden game. But this is why they got Chris Paul. Because when James Harden is not clicking, they have somebody else to give the ball to that can go and facilitate the offense and get his own in Chris Paul. But there's some bad news here too, because Chris Paul got banged up late in the game and he really couldn't continue. I mean, the Rockets pretty much had the game won at that point, so they didn't need Chris Paul. But this is a huge, huge blow to the Rockets if Chris Paul cannot play in Game 6, and then of course if there's a Game 7, okay? Last I checked, I mean, I was trying to check Twitter as soon as the game ended, get some reports on Chris Paul, and it's saying that he is, you know, highly unlikely to play in Game 6, so it's not looking good, folks, for Chris Paul. And if he is indeed not able to play in Game 6, this would seem like a moral victory, really, but prayers up for Chris Paul. Hopefully he's fine. Hopefully he plays in Game 6 because we all want to see that. But he was huge today. The main reason the Rockets won. Another reason the Rockets won today was they just played like the more desperate team, folks. Straight up. I mean, let's put the numbers aside for a second, because I know you can't really sort of quantify stuff like desire and heart and whatnot. But you saw it today. After every loose ball, the Rockets were there. Every 50-50 ball, the Rockets were there. They just wanted this game a lot more than the Warriors did. The Warriors did everything they could to blow this game, and they certainly did it, and the numbers show it. 16 turnovers for the Warriors, just 10 for the Rockets. But more importantly, 18 points off those turnovers for the Houston Rockets that the Golden State Warriors had, so they were able to capitalize it. Like I said, watching this game, it just looked like Houston wanted the game more, and they played like it. Golden State did not play like it. Just too many careless turnovers. Kevin Durant, I mean, my God. I know he still put up, what, 29 points and 4 rebounds, but the buckets late in the fourth quarter, nothing going for him, just taking inadvertent shots. He was just absolutely awful. Like I said, Steph Curry was the best player for the Warriors today, 22-10-6, but he could not get anything going today with his teammates. You saw at the end, Draymond Green got that pass from Curry. He completely bobbled it. That was all Draymond with the butterfingers pass, and that pretty much sealed the win for the Rockets. And Klay Thompson, I looked at the stat sheet after game, 23 points. It felt like the quietest 23 for Klay, because I thought he had a horrendous game, okay? So for the Rockets, they're playing like the desperate team. They're taking advantage of Houston, of Golden State's careless turnovers, and they're just capitalizing like any team should. And that's what I like about it. So what the Warriors need to do is they need to stop turning the damn ball over. They need to continue to go back to what they usually do, which is playing Golden State basketball, which is, you know, ball movement, crisp, clean, you know, ball handling and whatnot. They're just too sloppy right now. And if they do this again, they're not going to win the game. They're going to be eliminated. And it's crazy to think about it with the star power that they have on the Warriors. But with that being said, let's see what happens. Do I think the Warriors are done? Do I think Rockets are going to the NBA Finals? No, I do not. It's Golden State. You can never count them out. I have that same prediction with the other series in the Eastern Conference. I said after Boston won Game 5, I still think Cleveland's going to win this series. I still think Golden State's going to win this series. you could kind of say it's blind faith, but I'm willing to take those chances because even today, I mean, the Rockets played really well, but Golden State, even though they played awful, they were still in the game. They were still in the game, and so to me, that gives me some hope that the mistakes that the Warriors had, they can correct it. Like I said, some of the mistakes were just shots not dropping, and we're talking about three of the best all-time shooters, and their shots are going to drop. Okay, so in Game 6, I fully expect the Warriors to win in Golden State, and then Game 7 in Houston, that is where, of course, I believe it's going to be a close game. But I think Golden State could pull it out. But with that being said, obviously it's not going to surprise me if the Rockets win Game 7 in this series. They are playing like the more desperate team. That is what Golden State needs to do. They seem like the kind of kid that gets fat and happy after winning a championship, and they don't work for it as much. And Golden State needs to get back to playing desperate like the Rockets are playing, and they're going to want to correct that. So with that being said, that is what I think, folks. I think the Warriors are still, you cannot count them out. I still think they can win this series, but hanging on by a thread here again. Let me know what you guys think of the Rockets winning this series. If Chris Paul is done, I mean, I think you have to go with Golden State at that point, but we'll see what happens. The Rockets better hope CP3 is okay. They better hope CP3 is okay, because that is the difference for the Rockets. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys agree with me, leave a comment down below. Let's debate. Let's talk about it. Follow me on my social media. Hit me up on all of that good stuff. And as always, don't forget to subscribe. Thanks for watching.